Good Monday, everybody. Well, let's check out the tropics and see what's going on in the tropical outlook for today, Monday, the 22nd of June, 2020. My name is Jewel. Thank you so much for clicking play and checking all this out with me today here at J7409 Weather. In the Atlantic, we have this little system. Last evening, when I was having my live show, this had a popped up to maybe a 40% chance. Well, it's hitting some of that dry air and it's hitting the cooler waters and it's coming down in intensity. It's just a large low pressure system and it's about several hundred miles southeast of Cape Cod, Massachusetts. It is remaining disorganized and the low is moving slowly eastward just north of the warm waters of the Gulf Stream. A tropical or subtropical development will remain unlikely if this system remains in these unfavorable ocean conditions. And this system is expected to continue to weaken as it moves even over the colder waters late today and tomorrow. It's down to a 20% chance of forming. It's a different story in the eastern Pacific. And stick around, I want to show you a few things coming up in a moment. But right here, we do have disturbance number two, but first let's go over to disturbance number one. It's a broad area of low pressure also. It's more than 1,000 miles southwest of the southern tip of Baja California Peninsula. It's continuing to produce disorganized showers and thunderstorms, and the environmental conditions are expected to be conducive for some gradual development in this system. It could become a tropical depression during the next few days, and it's moving generally westward. It has a 40% chance of forming in 2 days and a 60% chance in 5 days. Now, disturbance number two is going to try really, really hard to develop, folks. It may become a high-end tropical storm. It may become a hurricane. I don't think so, but we'll have to wait and see. But it's going to be moving this way as I've looked and done some studying on it today. Looking like showers and thunderstorms associated with this broad area of low pressure is several hundred miles south of the southern tip of Baja California Peninsula. And it's showing some signs of organization. Now, environmental conditions are forecast to be conducive for gradual and additional development, and a tropical depression could form during the next 2 to 3 days while this disturbance moves westward away from the coast of Mexico. After that time, cooler waters are likely to inhibit further development. It's got a 50% chance in 2 days, 60% chance in 5 days. It's going to move up like this and then move up like this. And it's going to hit a little bit cooler water. So I'll keep my eyes on all of this. This is the eastern Pacific. There's nothing in the western Pacific and the Atlantic. We have that little system and it's going to die on out and not bother anyone. As we look at the satellite picture, here's a system that's out in the Atlantic now. You can see it is going to be getting into dry air up in here. Much less to say the water's much, much cooler up here. That dry air we've all been talking about and the cooler waters is going to tear that apart. As I'm looking at the dry air, though, we're supposed to have at least two waves of it. Well, this first wave is not that bad. As you can see, we have this huge high pressure up here. It's a Bermuda high. Huge, huge high pressure. It's pushing this down. But this Bermuda high is going to be coming down and moving eastward. So I'm going to have to keep my eyes on this. Now, as this moves up, I told you where it may come up. And right in this area, right in here, you may have some different looking sunsets in the next week or maybe a little longer. But the second wave coming off of Africa is much, much bigger. Look at the dry air. Dry air, dry air, dry air. Now, with this high pressure out here, it's going to come southward, but it's going to keep moving easterly a little too. We're going to have to wait and see how much of this dry air here actually escapes and comes down when it comes to the second wave. We're going to have to wait and see. I've done a little checking ahead of time on a few things, and by next month, I think Florida may have a, I'd say maybe the mid-July area, maybe a little later, maybe a little sooner, but somewhere in that area, you guys might have a tropical storm threat. Now, the same time, if you have this tropical storm threat come up to Florida, it's a threat. I didn't say it was going to hit, and it may not materialize. I'm just trying to give you a little heads up on some things I've looked at and studied this morning. But the same one should probably come over here in the Gulf, the same area, same time frame. New Orleans, Mobile, Jackson, Mississippi. This tropical storm threat may happen to you around the same time, sometime in mid-July or a little later. And then in Texas, very same time, mid-July or a little later in July, I think that same system may bring a hurricane threat to Texas. Now, none of this may materialize. I want to make that plain. But we've got to watch and see. If all of this comes off and gets out before then, or if it doesn't materialize and only some of it gets out because of that high pressure, all of that will make a difference. And that's a check of your tropical weather update for today. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe, click that bell, and check off all. Have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day. I love you all and thank you for everything you do for me. Peace, love, and kindness to each of you. Thanks for watching.